येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रृण्वन्नोतिभिस्सेद साधनम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेधसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीतायाः पतये नमः कूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरं आरुह्य कविताशाखां वंदे वाल्मीकिकोकिलं मनोजवं मारुततुल्यवेगं जितेन्द्रियं बुद्धिं वरिष्ठं वातात्मजं वानरयोथमुख्यं श्रीरामदूतं शिरसा नमामि। आत्मस्वरूप बंधुगण, सो आई एम हैप्पी दैट अवर आर्षविद्या गुरुकुलम स्टूडेंट्स आर ऑल हियर, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर हियर। It is like an outing for the students because they are going through classes continuously. So and we have a satsanga on a regular basis there. But today, instead of satsanga, this is also easygoing, some storytelling. So they are all here and a nice break for the routine. So, Hanumanapi Vikrantaha Sarvam Shushrava Tatvataha सीताया स्त्रिजटायाश्च राक्षसीनां च तज्जितम्। दिस इज एन इंटरेस्टिंग वे ऑफ टेलिंग स्टोरी इन रामायणम, नेमली ओके वन कैरेक्टर इज टेकन एंड दैट कैरेक्टर इज परस्यूड ऑन द स्टोरी लाइन क्वाइट ए लिटिल क्वाइट 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 सम फॉरवर्ड टेकन फॉरवर्ड क्वाइट सम लेंथ and then the character was left there and another character is taken. So like that, if Valmiki takes Sita, he pursues her at least 3, 4, 5 chapters, he pursues the story, then he leaves her there and then picks up Hanuman. So till the other class we have seen Sita, her suffering and her desperation, her trying to commit suicide. Then suddenly she sees some very auspicious omens and concludes that probably now the troubles are slowly coming to an end. What they call, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. So like that, the tunnel and all its darkness is now coming to an end. Probably you can see some light at a distance. So that is how she felt in that last moment of desperation, about to commit suicide. She received some indication from the omens that probably things will be better now. There we stopped. Now leave Sita there for a while. Hanuman Api Vikrantaha. So the 30th chapter starts with the name Hanuman. Hanuman Api, that Api indicates. So we have seen so much about Sita. What about Hanuman? Hanuman is also there, very much there only as part of the entire story. So he is also there, a very valorous person, a man of courage, person of courage and valor. He was the witness to the entire episode. Sita was there, she came, and she is now surrounded by these ogre ladies, the Rakshasa Stris, demonic ladies, and she was threatened by them. Rakshasinancha tajjitam, the Rakshasis, Rakshasa is a demon, male. Rakshasi is the female, like that. So the Rakshasis were threatening her. You agree to Ravana's proposal, so be his mistress or his queen. Otherwise you will be saved, otherwise you will be killed. Like that they were threatening her like anything. So Hanuman, sitting on that top of that tree, Shimshapa tree, he was a witness to all this episode. And then Trijata came into the scene. She saw a dream in the earlier night. She gave an elaborate account of that dream. And then she analyzed the dream and told them in a very convincing fashion. All these demons were told by her very convincingly that this dream indicates all good future for Sita and all bad things for this villainous Ravana. So that episode also he has witnessed from that tree. अवेक्षमाणस्ताम देवीम देवतामिव नंदने। सो सीता अपीयर टू हिम लाइक ए सेलेस्टियल लेडी sitting under a tree in a celestial garden. Nandana. Nandana is a garden. So you see, we have a heaven. And heaven has got all counterparts. What we have here, some counterparts are there. Like we have buildings here to live. So in heaven also there are some buildings. So then we have some gardens here. So in heaven also there are very beautiful gardens. Like we have wonderful gardens in this country. In every country they are there, but here they are a bit more. So heaven also we have very special gardens. And one of them, they count the 7 gardens are there. So one of them is Nandana. The name is a very interesting name. Nandayati iti Nandanaha. You enter that garden, your heart leaps with joy at the beauty. Therefore it is called Nandanaha. So in that garden there is a wonderful, beautiful tree, and underneath the tree a celestial lady was sitting. So how that scene would be? Hanuman felt that way to see Sita below that tree. Tato bahuvidham chintam chintayamasa vanaraha. Then so many thoughts came in his mind. In fact, if you expected Hanuman to come down and start a dialogue with Sita, you have to wait for it a little while. So many thoughts are there in his mind. So many speculations. So his mind is described a little here. Yāṁ kapīnāṁ sahasrāṇi subahūnyayutāni ca dikṣu sarvāsu margante seyamāsāditāmaya. You see, he says thousands and thousands of warrior vanaras. Vanara is a tribe-like thing. You don't say it kapi or monkey. So vanara it is. So warrior, great warriors of that vanara tribe, they are all roaming throughout the subcontinent of India in search of Sita. Every nook and corner they are searching. Everywhere they are searching. Like some girl is kidnapped in Oklahoma or somewhere, Nevada. They are searching the whole place, they are searching. Thousands of them are searching. Like that, Sita was searched for. And thousands were on that job. And suddenly one person found her. And that person is me. What a discovery it is. He was very thrilled by that. Aham ashvasayam yenam purna chandra nibhananam adrishta dukkhan dukkhasya nahyanta madhigacchatim. In her life, she has not known what is pain and suffering till the other day. And then suddenly she was kidnapped by Ravana. And at that moment when she kidnapped her, started a long period of intense suffering for her. You see, suppose you are accustomed to some suffering now and then some more suffering comes, you will be able to take it, like a shock absorber. But you don't know what is suffering, everything went very cozy throughout the earlier years. Suddenly, the person is kidnapped and held captive by a very cruel, villainous person. So in an unknown place, and the people who are near and dear to you are nowhere to be seen, and no news about them, God knows whether they are alive or not. That kind of a horrible situation she found, and it is already 10 months old. She is weak, not eating food properly, and she was about to commit suicide also. So that way, the situation was very unhappy for her. She never knew what is suffering. The prince, the daughter of the emperor Janaka princess, and suddenly she finds herself in such dire straits. So what an misfortune. He is thinking like that. She is very beautiful. Purnachandra Nibhananam. And you see, if a rugged person, he falls down or he gets into some trouble, people also, okay, he can manage it. But such a delicate, tender, beautiful young lady falling into difficulties, it is a bad sight for anybody. So he says, I cannot leave her like that. I have to console her. Because just now she made an attempt to suicide, to kill herself. And then she took one step backwards. God knows she may do it again. So this time she may take it to the conclusion also. So let me not leave it like that. So I will try to console her a little. Because, you know, strictly speaking, Hanuman's job is fulfilled. If he has to work for the rule, they say, work for according to the rule. If that is the case, he need not stay there one more minute. He can fly back and tell to Rama, yes, I am supposed to find out the place, locate Sita, and I have done it. And she is in such and such a place. So, this is I have done. And Rama will be very glad about it. Because he has done his job. But Hanuman is something more than that. That's why he is worshipped so specially. So, in Telugu we have a proverb. Chuchiramante kalchi vachadu. That is how we say. Hanuman was asked to go and see whether Sita is there and come back and report. He was asked to do that by Rama, by Sugriva, by Jambavan, by Angada. Everybody, these are the leaders. They asked him to do that. That was his job. But he went there, saw her, and then continued further till such a point that he puts the entire Lanka to flames and comes back. Anyway, so the thought process behind that kind of a proactive policy is now being described. Very proactive, not just seeing and coming back, running back and telling, oh, I have saw it, not that way. Yadi yaham sati menam shokopahata chetanam anashvasya gamishyami doshavad gamanam bhavet. The thinking is like this. Here is a lady of high virtue, chastity, sati pativrata, and she is suffering. Her heart is broken with grief, shokopahata chetanam. And if I do not console her, give her some hope for the future and go back my way, then probably that kind of an action will be a mistake on my part. It could be a big mistake. Doshavat gamanam bhavet. And then Rama may find fault with me. How you came back like that? Saw her and came back running? You should do something about her safety also before returning. Like that he might point out. Gate himayi tatreyam rajaputri yashasvini paritranam apashyanti janaki jivitam tyajet. This Sita was living on the thread of a little hope that Rama will come one day and save me. That was the only small thread of hope that kept her alive. And if that small hope is somehow removed, it is gone, then she won't live one more day. Therefore, because that is how human life is, so I cannot leave her this way. If I leave her in this fashion, and just fly away from there itself, jump from that tree to another tree, and then cross the ocean and come back, then she may kill herself surely. Yathacha samahabahu purnachandra nibhavamaha samashvasayitum nyayah sita darshanalalasaha. Then he knows what is the situation of Rama back there. His heart was also broken. And so the separation from his beloved Sita was so painful to him. He was also in a similar situation. Being a man, he doesn't plan to commit suicide. That is the only difference. Otherwise, he was also desperately suffering. So, when I go back, he asks, did you hear Sita saying anything? Did you have one word with her? How is she? How she talks? That kind of a few questions he will ask. And my answer will be no, 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 no for everything. Then I will not have any way to console him. I need to console him also there after going back. Suppose I talk with Sita a few words and take a small message with me. So Sita said this. I can report it to him and he will be consoled automatically. Therefore, just going back at this point of time will be very big mistake on my part. Nishacharinam pratyaksham akshamam chabhibhashitam kathannu katu kartavya vidam kruchra gatohyaham. Okay, then what is the problem? You go and talk with her? No. She is surrounded by these ogre ladies, the demon ladies, and in their presence how I can talk? When they, all the guards, the jail guards are there, how you can go and talk with the person who is held captive? No way. So I cannot talk with her in their presence. They are around, they are a bit away from her, but still they are around in the same general area. And what to do now? Kathannu khalu kartavyam idam kruchira gatohyaham. I am in a very big dilemma. Kruchira is a sankatam, they call it. So dilemma. So I am thrown into a difficult dilemma. Anena ratrisheshena yadi nashvasyate maya sarvatha nasti sandeha parityakshyati jivitam. It was early morning 5. The sun has not yet risen. Sunrise is not yet taken place. Very, very early morning time it was. So we have seen all that. And so half an hour of the night is still left. In another half an hour it will be daybreak. And within this half an hour, before the day breaks and all activity in the city of Lanka resumes, all the people are out of their beds and they are all on the roads moving around, so some more people will come here. Then talking with her becomes all the more difficult. Therefore, within this half an hour time, when people are still within their within the doors in the houses, there is not much of a movement around. Only a few of them are there. This is the ideal time to talk with her. So I should utilize this half an hour remaining night time to console her. If I don't do that, there is no doubt that she will not live longer. Parityakshyati jivitam. Then, so all his thinking is presented in some vivid detail. Ramastu yadi pruchenmam kimmam sita bravidvachah kimaham tam pratibruyam asambhashya sumadhyamam. I already anticipated it and told it. Rama will ask me, you saw Sita, yes. Did she say anything? Did you say anything to her? Say, did you say hello to her? Did she reply? Like that he will ask. And then my answer will be, no, it did not occur to me to have a word with her. Like that if I say, then he will be most disappointed. So it will be silly to give that kind of a reply. On my part, I should not do that. Antaram tvahamasadya rakshasinam avasthitah shanai rashvasayam yadya santapa bahula mimam. Then he says, my goodness, this is a very good opportunity. These ladies who have surrounded her all around her now till now, they seem to be moving a little away. Some chores will be there. They too cannot sit all the time looking at her, you know. So they have to move around for some daily chores. Antaram tvahama, I find a way in. They are not there that much surrounding her. And my goodness, this is the opportunity. I should not lose it. I slowly approach her. Santapa bahula mima, my goodness. She looks like the suffering and sorrow. If sorrow incarnate, that is how she looks. So you can't find a person with more sorrow than her. So I should do something about it. Aham hyati tanushchaiva vanarascha visheshatah vachan choda harishyami manushimiha sanskrutam. He looked at himself. Oh, I am too big. Like, not like a normal human being. I cannot present myself in this form. She will be frightened. Then, I am not a human being. I belong to a tribe called Vanara. So, I don't want to say monkey. I want to hold on to the word Vanara only. Because this monkey could be a bit problem. So, monkey cannot speak. Monkey cannot be a scholarly. Whereas this man, he is a scholar, Hanuman. Therefore, Vanara. Narova, is he a human being only? That is Vanaraha. It is not just a monkey. Though the word kapi is also used, vanaraha is rova. Is he a human being? Something like that. Close to a human being. That's why we say, many scholars say a particular tribe. Because Rama was assisted by all the tribes people. That is a viewpoint. Anyway, so this vanara, I am a vanara, I am not a human being like Sita and Rama, they are. So, over and above that, I have a very bigger body. Then, so which language I have to use her? How to address her? So, there are some words which do not belong to any language. Hey, oh, this kind of words. Should I use them? Or should I use our dialect? She may know it, may not know it. what language? So he says, human beings often they converse in Sanskrit. Manushimiha Sanskritam. So that Sanskrit, it's a Sanskrit language, highly refined language, because in those days that was the spoken language. So he's a scholar in that language, Hanuman. So I will use that language to address her. That is what he is thinking.
Yadivacham pradasyami dvijatiriva sanskrutam ravanam manyamanasa mam sita bhita bhavishyati.
Then he got another thought. My goodness, how? If I speak in Sanskrit, Ravanasura is a scholar of Sanskrit. He speaks in Sanskrit only. And he can assume any disguise. He came in the form of a sannyasi, a monk, and kidnapped her. Now, and that idea was there in her mind all the time. This Ravana is a very tricky guy. He can assume any form. Earlier he appeared as a monk and kidnapped and deceived me. She was deceived that way. She thought she should pay some respects to the monk and she came forward and he kidnapped her. So now if I appear, she may look at me and think that the same Ravana came, and that idea will be strengthened by the language, because you can disguise, but the language you cannot change, you know. That's why these spies, etc., who disguise, they learn the language of the other place also. Otherwise the language will betray him, will give away. So if I use Sanskrit, she immediately connects, because till now Ravana was there and he spoke for half an hour. All that was Sanskrit language. And so, my goodness, if I use Sanskrit, she may think that the same Ravana went this way, changed the form, shape, came, put on a disguise and came back. She may think like that. And then she will be shivering with fear. She won't receive me with any confidence.
Avashyameva vaktavyam manusham vakyamarthavita maya santvayutum shakya nanyatheya manindita.
But there is no other alternative. That is the only course left for me. So I have to speak in Sanskrit. If I do not use the Sanskrit language to speak, to address her, then there is no way, there is no alternative to console her. So either you console her by talking in Sanskrit, or move away. There is no third alternative. Therefore he now concludes to address her in Sanskrit. That is one point settled.
Seyam alokya me rupam janaki bhashitam tatha rakshobhistrasita purvam bhuyastrasam upaishyati.
Then about his form. So she is already very suspicious of her surroundings. So she is scared beyond her wits. And so if she sees me in this full form of vigor and vitality, energy and ruggedness, etc., she thinks that I am one more demon, and she will be further frightened. And that kind of a fright can bring a heart attack, etc., and cause a death or other problems also. So once the language aspect is settled, now he has to settle about his form. He also can assume any form of his choice. He can condense himself, he can expand himself, like we do with our ribcage and all that. So he can do it much better than that. So he has that capacity.
Tato jata paritrasa shabdam kuryan manasvini jananamam vishalakshi ravanam kamarupinam.
This young lady, once she is scared very much, if she thinks that I am Ravana, if that idea occurs her mind, then immediately she will cry loud. Big crying she will start. Oh my goodness, what is my fate? This man again came. Like this she will cry. And once she cries loudly, all these demon ladies who are just moving away a little, they will be coming back. They will be attracted and they will come back. Again my purpose will be disturbed. How to do that?
Sitayacha.
So he imagines it to its conclusion and then takes a decision.
Sitayacha krute shabde sahasa rakshasi ganaha nana praharano ghoraha sameyadantakopamaha.
When Sita cries like that, then not only these demon ladies who were surrounding her will come back, but at the same time these guards who were standing a little away and who are busy otherwise, they will all be attracted, their attention will be drawn here, and or somebody will send a message to them like 911. So they come running. They will come running. And once they all come, they will attack me. Now, what will happen if they attack me? He is not afraid of that. His thinking is like this. He says, Kamam huntum samarthosmi sahasranyapi rakshasam. I can kill not one or two of them. I can kill 1,000 of them in one stroke. That is not my problem. He is not afraid of many gods coming and attacking him, and therefore he will be injured or killed. That is not his fear. He says, I can kill 1,000 of them. That is not the problem. The problem is, natu shikshyam yaham praptam praptum param param mahodadehe. After this battle, etc., I have to go back by crossing this ocean, this strait, 100 miles wide. The strait has to be crossed by me. If I am injured in the battle, then I will not be able to cross it. Or if a big group of these demons attacks me and makes me captive, they capture me, then I will be held back. Then I will not be able to cross. So that should not happen. Otherwise, they are all waiting for him to bring a good news. So that is a problem. Then he says, you know, asatyani cha yuddhani samshayo me narochate. At one moment he said, I can kill 1,000 of them. But now he says, we should not be so arrogant also. Because these yuddhas, you know, these battles, you cannot really tell. It is like a football match. The best team may be defeated on a given day. It is like that. Of course, their skill and good effort, all other factors, they weigh upon the result. They dictate the result, all right. But on a given day, any team can win and any team can be defeated. So pure luck also is important. If the luck is not in my favor, I may be defeated also. It's not necessary that I should win all the time. So, samshayome narochite. I don't want to enter into a situation where the outcome is in doubt. Because everything else will be spoiled if I spoil the situation here. Then he says, kascha nissamshayam karyam kuryat prajnyaha sasamshayam. Where there are doubts in terms of outcome, that kind of a situation is turned to an advantage such that the outcome is not in doubt. One who can do that way, he alone is a wise man, wise person. And I have to do that kind of a wise thing, not I tried that I will win but finally I lost, what I can do. Like that I should not say later. There will be no time for regretting and all that. Everything will be destroyed. So, if I take a step, it should be assured of proper result. Esha dosho mahan hisyato mama sita abhibhashane. So, if I approach Sita and try to address her, this kind of a danger is there. Then, okay, then don't do that. Pranatyagascha vaidehyaha bhavedana abhibhashane. If I don't reveal myself and have a word with her and console her, if I don't do that, she will commit suicide. This is what is called sankata, a dilemma. Not a simple dilemma. It is a simple dilemma is okay, you can do this way or that way, nothing big deal. It's not a simple dilemma. Whether to go by 78 or whether to go by 22, it's not that kind of a dilemma. It is a life and death dilemma it is. So either you succeed and live or you fail and die. That kind of a dilemma. Bhutaschartha virudhyanti deshakala virodhitaha viklavandutamasadhya tamasuryodaye yatha. A spy, he is a spy, you know. A spy should be able to assess the dilemmas very appropriately. If the spy cannot resolve a dilemma properly and he makes a mistake, everything will be destroyed. And the secret of a king or kingdom is in his hands. If he is caught by the other party, then the kingdom will suffer. Everybody will suffer. So this spy has to be very intelligent and deshakala avirodhataha. Whatever action he takes, it must fit into the time and space situation. He should improvise his original plan according to the time and space. He cannot say, this is my plan and I go according to that, what I can do. He cannot say that later. He will not be there to say that. He will be just destroyed then and there. So just improvise upon the situation and take appropriate step. That is, this is all thinking in his mind, all speculation. Hanuman.
Navinashyet katham karyam vaiklavyam na katham mama langhananca samudrasya kathannuna vrutha bhavet.
Still his ideas only are being coming. So Valmiki is not in a hurry. He is a great poet and he continues with it in a vivid way. So I have taken up this project and it should not be a failure. How I have to do that? Then I have crossed the ocean, a strait I have crossed and came here. It was a very big effort. And if I spoil this, then the whole effort will be of no avail. It becomes in vain. It should not, like it is like a game in game ball. You know game ball? They say game ball, now game ball. Suppose the game you have to win in 30 points. So 29th point is game ball. You get that point, victory is yours. You spoil there, all the good game that you have played till then is a waste. So that game ball situation. So kathannu khalu vakyam me shrunuyan nodvijeta cha. I have to speak that kind of a language. The language is decided, Sanskrit. I have to use that kind of a speech such that she will recognize me. At the same time, she will not be excited. It is like waking up a person sleeping in between four people, four hostile people. You have to wake up that person only. You cannot, should not wake up any one of them. That kind of a thing it is. So, how to do that? She has to listen to what I say. She should not get excited. She should not be scared. If she is scared, then everything is spoiled. My goodness, how to do it?
Iti sanchintya hanumanuschakara matiman matim.
He is a matiman, so buddhiman. We say Hanuman, he stands for wisdom and fulfillment of a job using the mind, using buddhi, intellect. So he is worshipped that way. So people worship Hanuman and they expect that their wisdom will grow because of that worship. And this vadamala they call it, a garland of vadas. Vadas means donuts. These are donut shaped things, but they are a bit spicy and oily. Whereas donut is of a different kind. Shape is of donut, exactly like donut. And a garland is made and it is offered to the Lord. And then after the pravachanam is over, the offering is taken away and all people enjoy that. That is an advantage of the offering to the Lord. He won't consume it. If you offer to a person like me, I will put it in a bag and take home. You will not get anything. Whereas if you offer to Hanuman, it will be waiting with you. So, they do it in India, they do it all the time. Hanuman means they go with a vadamala and give it to the pujari. And pujari, he knows, it is all known to everybody. So he won't even protest. He takes it and puts it on to Bhagavan. And after 5 minutes, some naivedyam, just don't do even naivedyam, just put on, that is the naivedyam. And after 5 minutes, he will bring it and give back to you. They open it then and there, and take out some 5 or 10 of them and give to the pujari, and another 5 or 10 distribute around, and take the rest home. They make a very big mala, you know. So this is the how they worship Hanuman. All students worship Hanuman. They want wisdom. All people who work hard for physical strength, they worship Hanuman. All gymnasiums, gyms, you know, all gyms are called Hanuman Vyayamshala. Every one of them is called Hanuman Vyayamshala. Without exception. Everywhere you find them. They are called gym, they are gyms there. So, anyway, now he takes a decision like this. How to address her? He is coming to a decision, very unusual and most unexpected course he will take. Very very intelligent way. You just think like that is how I felt about it.
Rama Maklishta Karmanam Subandhu Manukirtayam Nainam Udveja Yishyami Tadbandhu Gata Chetanam.
He looked at her one more time. Every time she was remembering Rama. Hey Rama, where are you? Hey Lakshmana, I did not follow your advice. Hello, hey Kausalya, I am your dear daughter-in-law and I may not see you once again in my life. She remembers her parents, she remembers her in-laws, a husband and husband's brother. She is continuously remembering them in her grief. So, and when he saw that situation, he understood, okay, I will do this. What I will do, you know, I will not straight away go there. I will not say hello. I will not say, oh Sita, etc. I won't do any of those things. I will sit where I am and start singing the glory of Rama and see how she reacts to that. She must react favorably. Hopefully, she will react favorably. That is the decision he took. It is Srimad Ramayana Valmiki Adi Kavya Sundarakanda Trimshas Vargaha 31st. Evam Bahuvidham Chintam Chintayitva Mahamatihi Samshrave Madhuram Vakyam Vaidehya Vyajaharaha. You see, do you know what is this? I tell you how it is. In Bombay, I saw a gentleman on a railway platform. I saw him a few years back. But I could not remember whether he is the same person or not, because I see many people and I meet hundreds of them. So I could not recognize. He is not looking at me, and I saw him in that crowd and I have to draw his attention. Now I don't even remember his name. So what should I tell him? Sir, I saw you a few years back, I don't know your name, how it looks. Then I remember one thing. I saw a book in his hand. That book is Rudradhyaya. That is that book, I could see that name. So that was there in his hand. Then he sat on a bench. Then I went and sat a little away from him there. And then slowly started reciting Rudra. I know Rudra. Namaste Rudra. Like that, I sat like that. And people do that in India. They do it all the time. They are devotees. They can recite whatever they want anywhere they like. Who prevents? So I sat there. Namaste Rudra. Manjama Uto Reshavirma. Namaste Sudhanvane Bahubhya Matate Namaha. He looked at me. And then I said, hello. Then, sir, I know you. Yeah, I too know you. So like that it came. So, this is the system adopted by Hanuman. She loves the word Rama. She was uttering the word Rama, Rama all the time. And so, you just say Rama, Rama like that with devotion. Not like Ravana. I will kill him, this and that. So, with devotion you say that, and then her attention will be drawn towards you favorably, and probably she will not be excited unnecessarily. She will not be scared away. Probably, that is the best course that occurred to him. So he started it. Madhuram Vakyam. He was not looking at her, he did not go near her. He stayed where he is. But he started reciting in a way that it falls, the sounds go on, fall in her ear. He said, he did not start straight away Rama. It doesn't look proper. It should not appear like a contrived thing, you know. So he said, Raja Dasharatho Nama Ratha Kunjarava Jiman. They give a lot of importance to these, all these things in Kathavachakas. They make a big deal out of it, really. There is a lot of beautiful poetry and all that. Punyashilo Mahakirtihi Ikshvakunam Mahayashah. He was speaking in himself a bit loudly. There was a king once upon a time. His name was Dasharatha, a great man. He used to lead the army, a fourfold army, the army of chariots, elephants, and horses, Ratha Kunjara Vajiman, and of course foot soldiers. So a fourfold army he used to lead. And Punya Shilaha, very powerful man, all right, but a very gentle person. A very magnanimous and good-hearted man, Mahayashaha, he is well-known. He is not an unknown person. So, he was born in the clan of Ikshvakus, and he brought name and fame to the entire clan. Like that he started telling, Dasharatha. Rajarshinam gunashreshtaha tapasa charshibhissamaha. Among the kings, this Dasharatha was the foremost in taking care of his subjects, in safeguarding the society under his rule. But at the same time, among the sages he was foremost to. He was not inferior in penance and other things. Tapasacha Rishivhissamaha. He was living in the palace, yet he is not inferior in penance, in understanding, in the spiritual growth, to some of the mendicants and others who were doing penance in forests. He was similar to, equal to them. That kind of a great virtue he has. to become a rishi you need not go to a forest. You can stay in a city and be a rishi. You may stay in a forest and be an unhappy guy. So he was a very great person.
Chakravarti kule jatah purandara samo bale.
He was the emperor, his father and his grandfather, the entire clan is that of emperors. He was as great as Indra, the lord of heavens.
Ahimsa ratihi.
Ahimsa was followed by him in his life, non-injury. He is a king. He could be arrogant and cause injury to any number of people, but he never did that. Ahimsa ratihi. He lived a life of non-injury. Akshudraha. He has a very big heart, very magnanimous person. Gruni, very compassionate person, but satya parakramaha. If he is challenged in a battlefield, he will not be all this. He will destroy the enemy. That kind of a very strong man.
Mukhyasvekshvakuvamshasya lakshmivan.
He brought so much glory and wealth to the clan of Ikshvakus. Lakshmivarthanaha. He is very beautiful and a very powerful person. He described Dasharatha like that. Sita was hearing. Are? Miss Lanka? What is her idea? Just I am anticipating. In this Lanka, who is saying a few good words about my father-in-law? Anyway, Hanuman continues. He is not talking with her. He is speaking loud. His thinking is over, he is speaking loud.
Tasya putra priyo jyeshtaha.
That Dasharatha Maharaja had a few sons, and of them, the elder son is dearest to him. And Taradhipa Nibhanana, he is a very beautiful person, his elder son. Like a moon, a full moon he used to shine, very beautiful face. Ramo Nama, his name is Rama.
Visheshajnaha,
a very great scholar. So just because he is a prince, he is not a dumb person, very great scholar.
Shreshthas Sarvadhanushmatam.
He says, this is said quite often about Rama. Even in Krishna in Gita says it. Shankaracharya says it. Among the people who practiced archery, you know, archery as a means of warfare, that was the main thing, like a gun now, sniper shooting, etc. In those days it was archery. So among the people are the warriors who practiced archery. He is the foremost, and any other name will come later to him.
Ramas Sarvadhanushmatam Shrestaha.
Whosoever cared to hold a bow and arrow in his hand, he stands second to Rama, not equal to Rama. And so that way Rama is known, and Hanuman is presenting that way. Rama is of that caliber. Then what is this Rama?
Rakshita Swasya Vruttasya.
Vrutta is conduct. He very jealously guards his conduct. He doesn't allow any blemish to enter into his conduct. Svasya vruttas. It starts like that. People bring others into discipline. I am in the house, everybody should be disciplined. Okay, everybody else is disciplined. And then this person sits in a sofa and smokes. What kind of discipline it is? So it should not be like that. Then you say all others should be disciplined. You should be disciplined first. Smoke means, I don't mean that it is a bad thing or any such thing. It is not good for health, for oneself and others also. That's why I said that. So some act of indiscipline, that is the example. So, whereas he protects, he guards his conduct. He doesn't allow his conduct to be loosened.
Svajanasya apirakshita.
He protects whosoever takes refuge with him, in him.
Sir, you have to protect me.
I am under your protection. You are my benefactor. You say that and he will protect you. Help me. You say that, he will help you. To the last extent he will help you. He will lose his money and he give you money to you. He will lose his life and safeguard your life. So svajanasya cha rakshita.
Rakshita jivalokasya dharmasya cha parantapaha.
As a prince, he takes it as his responsibility to protect all the subjects in his kingdom. And he dharmasya cha rakshita, he protects, he safeguards dharma in his life and also in the society.
Sabharyasaha sabhratra virav pravrajito vanam
At the same time, this Rama is committed to Satyam, truth. Truth is very important for him. He won't say a lie for the sake of convenience. And then he wanted to protect the truth of his father also. His father also is committed to truth. This Ramayana, Bharata, etc., they hang on, the entire story hangs on the thread of commitment to truth. Dasharatha Maharaja gave two boons to Kaikeyi, and she like giving a blank check. So she kept these two blank checks with her and submitted them a few years later. These are two blank checks. Now I am filling them with my boons. He said, okay, go ahead. He thought that she will ask for something, reasonable thing. The first boon is Rama should go to the forest. He was willing to give that boon. Bharata, my son, should be made the king, the next king. Dasharatha Maharaja was very unhappy about it, because Rama has to come to the throne, not Bharata. He said, okay, you have your way. Is it okay? Is it all right? No, I have a second boon. What is that? Rama should be banished to the forest for 14 years. He could not stomach that boon. He could not reconcile himself to that. He said, why you want that? You leave alone. Rama, you leave alone. You have Bharata, kingdom to Bharata. But she says, no, we are not, I am not relenting. So, then it is now the duty of Rama to protect the father's truth, whether the father stands by the boons which he has granted or not, whether he follows his he keeps his promise or not. That is the issue. If Dasharatha said, I don't remember of giving any boons to you, then there is no Ramayana. And if Rama says, if you gave boons, why should I suffer for that? Then also there is no Ramayana. It just hangs on the thread of keeping the promise given. That is what is called Satyabhisandha. This word Abhisandha is used in Gita. Sri Krishna uses it, and of course Valmiki uses it. So there it is Phalabhisandha. Phalabhisandha means a person who is very greedy and very committed to the results of actions, and that is considered not proper. Whereas here it is Satyabhisandha, means he guards his promise, he keeps his promise, and he guards his truth with all greed and commitment. That is the Satyabhisandha. He won't say a lie. That is how this Rama was like that. Rama is like that. Dasharatha was also like that. So Rama took it upon himself to fulfill the promise given by his father. So accordingly he started on the journey to forest. And then his brother also followed him, one of the brothers. And his wife also followed him. As if he did not see her, as if he has nothing to do with Sita, etc. He is talking to himself. His wife also followed.
Janasthana atena tatra maharanye mrugayam paridhavata rakshasa nihata shuraha bahavah kamarupinaha.
So this Rama came to the forest with his dear brother and his beloved wife. And there they were living in the Dandaka forest, in the Deccan plateau, which is covered with forest in those days. And then there was a conflict, a battle between him and a group of Rakshasas. So the details are there in Aranyakanda. They are 14,000 commando unit it is. And Kara, Trishira, Dushana, these are the three demons who were the commanders. And so they came to attack Rama and kill him. They picked up a quarrel with him, and so they wanted to kill him. But what happened is, Rama has killed every one of them. He just did not allow anybody to escape. All the that day, in half an hour or 45 minutes time, all the 14,000 cadavers were there on the battlefield, and blood has flown like a river. And the whole place was slimy with the masses of bones and flesh. That is how it happened. And the whole area in the sky is filled with the thousands of vultures. That is how it happened. A very gory scene. He has killed every one of them. only two or three of them could run away. Whosoever faced him with a weapon is killed. So then janasthanavadham shrutva nihatau kharadushanau tatastvamarshapahruta janaki ravanenatu. These 14,000 commandos and this Kara and Dushana, they were the commanders of Ravana. He has kept a small army in the Deccan Plateau. It is his army. So they are his cohorts. So when the news came to Ravana that this is what happened, Ravana could not stomach it. My goodness. He is a great enemy. Now, but Ravana did not have the courage to face Ravana. So what he did, you know, out of jealousy and being unable to face Rama and challenge Rama, he could not do that. He was afraid. And so what he did, he has taken this course, wrong course of kidnapping Sita. He wanted to hurt the person, kidnap him. This is what the villains do. So a person is there, you want to hurt him, you want to bring him to knees, you want to make him yield to you. So what they do? Kidnap his son or daughter or his wife. This kind of a thing. That is a very bad thing to do. That is villainy. And that is what Ravana has done. Vanchayitva vane ramam rugarupena mayaya. So this Ravana, he has managed a big deceit. So he sent one golden deer before Sita. And her attention was attracted. And then the deer runs away. Rama runs behind it. Lakshmana was also attracted in the same direction by further deceit. And Sita is now left alone for a short time of 10 minutes. And then he came with further deceit, like a monk. Monk, you see, what an unfortunate thing it is. He comes as a monk, and so will anybody respect a monk again? So he doesn't even bother about it. He came as a monk, like a sannyasi, and then kidnapped her. My goodness. What a horrible thing he has done. And he is saying all that. Samargama, up to this Sita knows. Beyond this she doesn't know. She was listening. Then what? Samargamanasta. So he is quick in offering the further information. Samargamanastam devim ramas sita maninditam. See, the poor lady, what is her fault in it? Why she should be kidnapped? Anindita. If there is some grievance against Rama, he should come and challenge Rama. He should not attack his consort like that. But Rama was heartbroken. He started in search of her. And so that is the first information that she received. That Rama was searching for me. She did not know it. Now she knew it. Asasadavane mitram sugrivam namavanaram. Now he is introducing another character, utterly unknown to her. This Rama, while on his way in the forest, searching all over, all around, he came across a person called Sugriva, belonging to the Vanara clan. Then this Sugriva has got one enemy within the same clan. He is an adversary, a very dangerous and powerful adversary. His name is Vali. So he introduced that character also. Just to indicate to Sita that Rama is still the same old Rama. He has not mellowed down or any such thing. Even in spite of grief, if he takes the bow into his hand, the enemy is no more, he cannot stand on his legs. He falls like a dead body. He continues to be the same. Just to give her that idea, tatasavali namhatva ramah parapuranjayah. Rama's enemy cannot live happily. Because Rama is such a great warrior, so he killed this Vali, who happens to be an adversary to Sugriva, and then the entire kingdom now came into the hands of Rama. That is the rule in those monarchy days. This king goes and attacks the other king, and a war ensues, and in that battle this king kills the other king, then the entire kingdom comes to him. This is how British have captured the entire India. Clive has captured. Not only India, all colonies, British colonies were captured like this. Even in American colonies, they were captured like that. So, this is the rule of the game. Even Columbus, when he went around the world, whichever continent he discovers, that will become a colony of Spain. That is understood. Like that, many colonies in Mexico, etc., many colonies, they belong to Spain for a long time in history. So this was the rule. So as per that rule, as per that norm, that the Vanara kingdom now came into the hands of Rama. But he did not keep it for himself. He gave it to Sugriva. Recently, I went into internet for some work. So there was a site. Some site is there in internet, and I was there. There, do you know the following truths? Like that, there were a few truths. The first truth is, in the last 10,000 recorded history of humankind, world history, there is only one nation which never committed an aggression against another nation, and that is India. That is written. That is the truth. India did not commit an aggression. In the entire, India has the biggest history, the longest history it has got. Its history goes back to Rigveda period, which is 10,000 years. And since then till today, when we have an army standing against the Pakistan army on the borders, we have not committed the aggression. It is always others who committed aggression. British have invaded the country, then Portugal invaded, France invaded and made colonies. Then before that, Mughals have invaded from Arabia. Like that, then before that, Shaka, Yavana, Alexander has invaded Yavana. They invaded, but India never invaded. Pakistan has invaded, China has invaded in recent history. India has never invaded. And the reason for this, I have my own way of looking at the social history. My personal opinion is, India lives by the culture and the dharma norms of social life established by Rama. When I started this Sundarakanda, I have made some analysis of this social issues long, long back. So this point I did not tell at that time. This is another point. Therefore, there is no aggression on the part of India. Vajpayee will not commit aggression. Indira Gandhi did not commit aggression. Then 1 crore refugees came into India from Bangladesh because of internal conflict between Pakistan and East Pakistan and West Pakistan. She fed these 1 crore people. India is a poor country, yet it feeds these refugees. They are called refugees. 1 crore of them were fed for 2 years. And every one of them was sent back to Bangladesh safely. And Bangladesh was liberated. India did not occupy Bangladesh. It liberated it and gave it to Mujibur Rahman. Like even, that is Rama's culture it is. Rama gained Vanara Rajyam into his fist, gave it to Sugriva. And Sugriva is the king, not Rama. Rama stayed in a cave in the nearby forest. He did not even enter into the city. Because that rule was there. Rule means he has taken a vow not to enter into a city for 14 years. Dikshu sarvasu so ayachat kapirajyantu Sugrivaya mahatmane. Sugriva is a great man. He deserves that kingdom. And so Rama handed over the kingdom to him. Sugrivena abhisandishtaha harayah kamarupinaha. Then Sugriva immediately, he took it upon himself to help Rama to return the good turn, so to help him to locate Sita, his beloved wife, and so he has a big army of these Vanaras under his command. They were sent in all directions in search of Sita. Dikshu sarvasu tan devim, he says, that great woman, that is how he says, he is not talking to her, so he has to appear that way only. So he says, all these Vanaraviras, they are thousands in number, very big number. They are roaming all over the continent, subcontinent, in search of that great lady. And I am here. I am one of them. I am here. And a person called Sampati. Aham Sampati Vachanat Shatayojanamayatam. I happen to be one of those Vanaras. So like that he is speaking to himself. You know, a person in some sort of a trouble, he speaks to himself. They sit on a platform, a railway platform, and he speaks like, this is how I am, where I am, like that. He is speaking to himself. So Sampati was there. This Sampati gave me an hint that probably Sita is in this Lanka, in this island Lanka. And based on that Sampati's word, I had to cross this entire strait. I have to cross it, and I indeed managed to do that, and here I am.
Tasya hetor vishalakshyah samudram vegavan plutah.
Rama used to say that she is a very beautiful lady and all that, so very charming countenance she has, like that she described her, and I am now searching for her. For her sake I have done such a long journey, crossed the ocean and arrived here.
Yatha rupam yatha varnam yatha lakshmavatin chatam ashrausham raghavasyaham seyamasaditamaya.
Now he allows the cat to come out of his bag. Rama has described that lady to me. He has described her color of the body, her fair color, etc. Yathavarna, how she looks like, how tall he is, is she fat or is she lean, all those things he described. And not only that, he has described a few marks, identification marks. Lakshma is identification mark. So a mole here, this here, that there, like that. He described that. And based on all this description, I have an idea that probably I found her. Seyam asadita maya. I think I have found her. And he stopped.
Virara maiva muktva savacham vanarapungavaha.
And he stopped. He did not speak anymore. Janaki was listening to the whole story. Her attention was riveted on these sounds. What is going on?
Janaki chapita chrutva vismayam paramangata.
My goodness. She was stunned out of her wits. What is going on?
Tatasa vakrake shanta sukeshi kesha samvrutam unnamya vadanam bhiruhu shinshapa manva vaikshata.
Her hair was very beautiful, very long hair, very dense, very black. Because you know, from above only hair appears. And she was very scared also. She is not sure of herself, bhiruhu. Then she raised her head like that and saw unnamya vadanam. She is still scared. That fear is there. Shimshapa manva vaikshata. She saw these branches of the tree. Very dense tree. She was looking like that.
Satirya gurdvanja tatha yathastat.
She saw like that. She could not recognize anything. Then she saw in an angular way. Then she felt that the neck was painful because she was very weak. Then again she saw down below.
Nirikshamana tamachintya buddhim.
Then she took a little more enthusiasm and then again saw. Now she saw Hanuman. Somebody sitting there.
Dadarsha,
whom she saw, Vatatmajam, the son of Vata, Hanuman, Vayudeva,
Suryamivodayastham.
Like, it is early morning, as I already told you, night is coming to an end in half an hour. The night is already over. And the sun is about to come there. So, this Hanuman looked like the sun rising in the east. He is red in color. So, quite a big fellow. So, Suryamivodayastham, the sun, who is on the mountain peak yonder. He sits on the mountain peak, you know, sun sits on the mountain peak. Similarly, the Hanuman, he sat on this high tree and he saw him. Who is this Hanuman? He is not some silly guy. Pingadhipate Ramatyam. He is the closest of the ministers of Sugriva, the king of Vanara kingdom. That is what he is. He is not a simple person. Pingadhipateha amatyam. So he was sitting there and she saw him. It is Srimad Ramayana. So this is what you are waiting for. So that is the significance of Vadamala also.
It is Srimad Ramayana Valmiki Adikavya Sundarakanda Ekatrimisha Sargaha Tatashakantarelinam Drishtva Chiritamanasa Veshtitarjunavastram tam vidyut sanghata pingalam.
She saw him. She could not see him clearly first because he was hidden partially. There are many branches and sub-branches. He was sitting in between them. Through all these obstructions, she saw him. And her heart skipped a beat. Chalita manasa. She was very much stunned by this scene. He he was trying to hide himself in those branches, leenam. He is not exposing himself fully because he is not sure yet. And she noticed that he was wearing a white dhoti. You see, I told you, he is a vanara tribe person. He is not a monkey. Veshtita Arjuna Vastram. So he is like a human being. Var Narova. So Vidyut Sanghata Pingalam, he is red. The monkey features are there, you know. So he is a very red colored monkey. So it is like a mass of clouds is there, and suddenly you see a string of lightning you see in the mass of clouds. It is red. Lightning could be red, brilliant red. So some example, you know. So like that, all this dense foliage is there, and within that foliage, like a lightning, she saw him.
Sadadarshyakapin tatra prashritam priyavadinam.
He saw her seeing him, and immediately he became like this. Prashritam. Vinaya. Prashrita means devotion, humility. Amma, I am here at your command. That kind of a message he is sending to her by the gesture. And the priyavadinam. Till then, every word spoken by him was very dear to her ears, as if mana was flowing into, falling on the ears. So that dear words he spoke.
Phulla shokot karabhasam tapta chami karekshanam.
All around him, he was red in hue, and all around him, the Ashoka tree, it is, the Shimshapar Ashoka, whatever. And the Ashoka, if this is not Ashoka, but all around the trees are Shimshapa, Ashoka trees are there, you know, that is Ashoka Vanam. So all these trees are in full bloom. All flowers, red flowers are there. And in between he is also there, like a big red flower, he is sitting there. So, and his eyes were like molten gold, tapta chami karekshana. Molten gold means brilliant yellow golden eyes he has. Gold means reddish like eyes.
Sathadrushtva harishreshtam vinitavadavasthitam.
He saw him. One of the strongest vanaras there. And vinitavat avasthitam. He continues to be in the same posture out of humility and doing namaskaram, so that he wants to gain her confidence before further venturing into a speech and all that.
So maithili chintayamasa vismayam paramangata.
She was really surprised. Not surprised. She was a thunderstruck like situation. Then she was thinking like this in her mind. Her thinking process has to be completed, has to come to an end, then she has to make a gesture, then Hanuman make further progress. Till then he has to wait. So she think, Aho bhimam idam sattvam vanarasya durasadam. Oh, what a body it is. What a frightening life form it is. A living thing it is. Not definitely not a human being. Therefore she says sattvam. It looks like an animal, but a frightening form, very powerful, durasadam.
And durnirikshyam idam matva.
I cannot even look at it for a length of time. You have to turn your head. You cannot look at it for a long time. Such a brilliant body it is. She thought like that, and she turned his head down.
Punareva mumohasa.
She went back into her fit of suffering and sorrow. So she says, she is like this, how?
Vilalapabhrusham sita karunam bhayamohita.
Exactly what he feared, that only happened. She was frightened, bhayam. That fear has gripped her heart, bhayamohita. And then out of uncontrollable fear, she was shaking and she was crying loudly. So,
Rama Rameti Dukkharta.
In that crying she says, Hey Rama, Rama, what happened to me? What is going on? What is my lot? What is my fate?
Lakshmaneti Chabhamini.
Hey Lakshmana, where are you? Your advice I did not follow. You see where I am. Like that, she went back into her that grief.
Rurodha Sahasa Sita Manda Manda Swarasati.
As she was crying, she doesn't have energy to utter these names Rama Lakshmana loudly. Manda Manda. Very weak voice it has become. That's why fortunately the attention of others was not drawn. Otherwise it would have drawn attention of others. So very mildly she was crying.
Satha drushtva harivaram vinita vadupagatam.
Then what Hanuman has to do? What he did is, he approached her a few steps down. From the higher branches, he came a little down. Now, he can't sit there only because he has to do something about it. She was crying and she turned her head away. So what he did, he came down. But he did not come down with force and vigor. Very calmly he came down. He continued to maintain that posture of utter humility. And he came down. Now she saw once again. She heard a little sound and saw up. He is approaching. My goodness, he is coming near.
Maithili chintayamasa svapnoyamiti bhamini.
It occurred to her suddenly that it is all a big dream. Hallucinations, you know. Out of suffering, the mind functions like that.
Savikshamana pruthubhugna vaktram shakamrugendrasya yathoktakaram dadarsya pingapravaram harham vatatmajam buddhimatam varishtam.
He is the foremost among the wise people. The wisdom lies in his approach towards her. Even this wise approach was so disastrous, not entirely disastrous, something can be retrieved out of it yet. But as of the moment, this wise approach also did not entirely succeed, you know. So, if he did not think properly, then what would have happened, you can imagine. So, her heart will get an attack and she will die then and there if he did not approach her properly. Anyway, she saw him. He has a very frightening face, very big face, and that too one of the jaws were broken. I told you the story of Hanuman. It was not a clean jaw. One jaw was broken and so it was a crooked jaw. Other jaw is fair, normal. This is a crooked jaw. So this kind of a distortion in the face, which would have been otherwise very beautiful, it has frightened her a little, or even more. So, but he looks very majestic, and she saw him that way.
Satam samikshyaiva bhrusham vipanna gata sukalpeva babhuvasita.
When she saw him a second time, her heart was broken in a way, and she became unconscious. Gata sukalpeva, as if she is dead. As if unconscious means not yet completely dead, life is there, but as though. So she became unconscious because she could not handle this scene. Chiren, and he was sitting there and waiting. What he can do? He was waiting for some movement in her. After 5 or 10 minutes, it looked like that five minutes looked like a few days or hours. And at last she stirred a little.
Chirena saujnam pratilabhya chaivam.
And she became conscious once again. So vichintaya masa vishala netra. Now she has opened her eyes very widely and saw him again. And now she says like this. She became unconscious and came out of the unconscious state, you know. So she thinks that she slept for a while. So she says,
svapno mayayam vikrutadya drishtaha shakhamruga shastraganair nishiddhaha.
Ayyo, I have seen a dream, a very bad dream I have seen. In this dream, I have seen an animal-like fellow or a person, a human-looking, human-shaped animal or animal-like human. Some shakha mrugendraha, I have seen him sitting on a big tree, and I don't know whether this kind of a dream is auspicious or not. I have a feeling that this is an inauspicious dream. Okay, if you conclude that the dream is inauspicious, then immediately you pray to the Lord. Let there not be any harm or injury befall me because the dream is a bad omen. Like that we pray. But her prayer, you see,
Svasyastu Ramaya Salakshmanaya Tatha Piturme Janakasya Rajnyaha.
When you see a bad dream, some disaster or calamity may befall upon the person who dreamt or his close near and dear. That is how it is like that, you know. A woman is like that. So, she says, this bad woman is there. Maybe some calamity may fall upon Rama. So she is praying, Swastyastu Ramaya, let Rama be safe and hale and healthy. Sa Lakshmanaya, let Lakshmana be hale and healthy. Then she remembered her father. Her father is alive, you know. Generally, a lady who is in distress, she remembers her parents. First, she remembers them. So, she remembered her father, and she thought, old father, how is he? I don't know. Probably this woman is connected to his health or whatever it is. He is in a long distance. I pray to the Lord that let him be safe and hale and healthy. That is the prayer. By the time she finished prayer, she understood that this is not a dream after all. She says, Swapno hinayam. No. I made a mistake. This is not dream. You know why? What is her reason? Nahi mesti nidra. When I had that long sleep, to have a dream also. Shokena dukkhena cha peeditayaha. This twofold suffering. One is a physical suffering due to weakness and fasting and not taking proper food. That is one. Second is the separation from her beloved. So both these put together have made sleep almost impossible for me. So I did not sleep that long as to have a very precise dream and all that. Sukham hime nasti yato vihina tenendu purna pratimananena. She says, where is a good sleep for me all these days? Once I was separated from that Rama, that dear Rama, from that moment onwards I did not know what is a good sleep. Therefore, when there is no sleep, where is the question of dream? Rameti Rameti Sadaiva Buddhya Vichintya Vacha Bruvati Tameva Tasyanurupancha Katham Tadartha Mevam Prapashyami Tatha Shrunomi. Now she has come to a conclusion. It is not a dream. Therefore, she says it is a hallucination. The mind has a capacity to present chimerical scenes before you based on intense passions. So, she says all that. I am all the time thinking Rama, Rama, saying Rama, Rama. Rameti, Rameti, Sadaiva, Buddhya, Vichintya. Vacham, Bruvati, Tameva. So always the mind is fixed to Rama, and the speech also Rama, Rama, Rama. There is no other speech. Therefore, when the mind is so much fixed to the Rama, like an obsession, then what happens? I hear sounds as though related to Rama, and see forms as though somehow distantly connected to Rama. So this is what happened. Now I know what it is. It is, after all, a hallucination. Aham hitasyadya manobhavena sampidita tadgata sarvabhava. She is just concluding, just adding some more logic to the same conclusion. So generally, when the same thought pervades your entire thinking process for days on, then you start seeing things before you. In the thin air, you suddenly start seeing your beloved and all such things happen. This is the trick. The mind plays all sorts of tricks. So this is one of them. Then she says, Kinkaranam tasya hi nasti rupam suvyakta rupascha vadatyayammam. How this could be a hallucination, I say? It cannot be a hallucination. You know, in hallucination, she thinks like this, logic. The rationale is like that. If you see a form, you see it for a while and then it just disappears. And it may reappear in a very loose way. It won't stand like a strong, tangible form before you. That is not how hallucination will be. Whereas this guy, suvyakta rupascha vadatyayam mam, he has got a very tangible form sitting there like a mass, and then he is speaking also. She saw him moving the lips a little in the last part of his address. He is speaking. I saw him speaking. How it could be hallucination? It cannot be. Then that means what? There is a glimmer of hope. That means it may be true. Then immediately she is praying to the Lord out of gratitude. Namostu vachaspataye savajirine. So devatas, the Indra, the Lord of heavens, my pranams to him. And his guru, that is Brihaspati, the Jupiter, my pranams to him.
Swayambhuve chaiva hutashanaya.
Swayambhuva is Hiranyagarbha, the Virat, the universal Purusha. My prostrations unto him. And Agni, who is the altar for worshipping all the devatas, my prostrations unto him. And then she says,
Anena choktam yadidam mamagrato vanaukasa tachya tathastu nanyatha.
Her prayer is like this. He seems to be a tribal person, vanaukasa. Vanaukaha is a tribal man, a tribal prani, a life form. She could not decide whether it is a human being or otherwise. So this tribal life form is there before me. It seems to be speaking in a very cogent fashion. And my prayer is nothing more. What all he spoke must be true. He should not prove to be another set of lies. Tachya tathastu nanyatha. That is the prayer. No other prayer. What all he spoke must be true.
Icharse Srimad Ramayane Valmiki Adi Kavya Sundarakande Dvatrimshah Sargah.
Once she made these gestures of prayer and all that, he could not make out what is going on. Some big movement is going on in her heart, that much is clear. So he thought, this is the time to make a little further approach.
Sovatiriyadrumat tasmat vidrumapratimananah vinitavesah krupanah pranipatyopasrutyacha.
Then he decided, the time of the sitting on the branches is over. He slowly leapt, lightly he leapt onto the floor. And then he stood by bending his knees, not just erect, just a little bending his knees like that. And his face was shining red, like Vidruma. Vidruma is a red bead it is. So, pagadam they call it in Telugu. So that is how a coral, a lump of coral, his face, that is the lump of coral. So like that his face was shining, and he vinita veshaha krupanaha. Krupanaha means dhyanaha, means very grief stricken, which he is, because by how you can stand with a flowing face before her. So very grief stricken and very polite, and humility was there. Pranipatya, he did a namaskaram. Upasrutya, took one step forward. Bas, he says, Tama Bravin Mahateja Hanuman Marutat Majaha Shiras Sanjali Madhaya Sitam Muturayagira. So he did like this, with very politely, like this. Not just like this, or like this, just like this.
Shiras Sanjali Madhaya.
We do that, you know, when we prostrate before Lord, we do like this. So he approached her, and with very sweet voice, he is talking to her. Now directly he is talking to her. First word spoken by him, directly addressing her, looking into her face.
Kanu Padma Palashakshi Krishta Kausheya Vasini.
He says, Amma, who are you? You are so beautiful looking. Your eyes resemble the petals of a lotus. And you seem to wear a very rugged, worn out cloth, sari. Krishta Kausheya Vasini. But the sari seems to be very valuable sari, but very old and worn out by continuous usage.
Drumasya Shakha Malamya Tishthasitva Manindite.
I have seen you just a few minutes back. You were holding on to that branch of a tree. Are you planning to do something about it? Why you were standing like that? What must be the reason for it?
Kimartham Tava Netrabhyam Varisravati Shokajam.
Are, why you are crying like that? Those beautiful eyes were flowing out with water all the time, that crying water. So tears, why it is happening like that?
He says, Pundarika Palashabhyam Viprakirna Vivodakam.
When you are crying and tears are flowing like that, it appears as if two lotuses wet with water are dripping water. That is how they are. Like that, again some poetry there.
Suranam Asuranancha Nagagandharva Rakshasam Yakshanam Kinnarananancha Katvam Bhavasi Shobhane.
I have a feeling that you do not belong here. You must be an angel fallen from the heavens. So there are varieties of angels, and he tells a few names of the angels, and you must be one of them. And are you one of the princesses in this kingdom of Ravana. Is that so?
Katvam bhavasi rudranam marutam vavaranane vasunam vavararohe devata pratibhasime.
He says, I don't consider you as a normal human being. You look like a devata, an angel. And he asks an interesting question. Just he is diverting her attention from her intense grief. So he asks one interesting question.
Kopadva yadiva mohat bhartaram asitekshane vasishtham kopayitvatvam vasi kalyanyarundhati.
I have a feeling probably you are Arundhati. Why Arundhati should be here away from Vasishtha? Probably you are angry with him for some reason, quarrelled with him, left him alone and arrived here. Probably are you that Arundhati? Like that he is asking. Like that he continues. He knows that she is Sita. And he will not wait for her to answer, no, no, I am not Arundhati, I am not this, I am not that. He himself answers all those questions to himself and says, you must be Sita. We'll continue in the next class.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Tatsat Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.
Ayodhya people won't say that. They will say Shri Ramachandra Arpanamastu. Okay.
Shri Ramachandra Varadhyam.
Okay. Dhupadipanantaram Shuddhachamaniyam Samarpayami Naivedyam.
Om Bhurbhuvasu Ahadasya Vibhurajam Bhukkudevasya Vibhurajam Amrutam Svamdhropasthamana Yobhatinatimandraparakam Nema Vidyuto Bhantibhudoya Bhasnehi Neva Bhantamanu Bhati Sarvam Tasya Bhasa Sarvabhadam Vibhati.
వడలు అందరికి డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ చేయించండి.
అది కేర్ఫుల్లీ రిమూవ్ అందరికి వడలు వందలు కాదు వందనము కాదు Thank you.